just that 62-yard run and what you saw there?
Matt made a great check. He called the run to the right side based off the defense. And as I was running outside, I just saw Laquan Treadwell dominating the cornerback. And as I passed him, he got off of the cornerback and blocked the safety. So it was really just a sprint for me, one of the easiest runs of the year. And I'm just grateful for it.
Even though the team didn't end the way that they wanted to, what did it mean to see the continued fight and never giving up in this final game?
You know, I think J.J. Watt said it best. We all pros. We get paid a lot of money to go out there and play 100%, not 50%, you know. And anybody giving less than 100% effort really doesn't deserve the chance to get paid and play in the NFL and complete their dream, you know. So every time I step on the field, I give 110%, and a lot of people on this team do the same.
Why do you think the run game has been so inconsistent for this team? And do you think that some people maybe weren't giving it their all? Like you said, you've been giving 110%.
It's just how the games go sometimes. Sometimes we get in great push, and sometimes the defensive line is doing their job. You know, they get paid too. So it's a constant fight. And as a runner, you kind of know that you're not going to hit the home run every time. You got to keep pounding. And eventually the defense is going to mess up and miss fit.
What was Raheem's message to the team in this loss, in this final game? That could be his final game as the head coach.
Really just he focused on us with the message, how we got to start stronger. But that was the great way we finished off the game. But it's really the tale of this season. We got to have a complete game. Sometimes we have a great first half, not so good of a second half. Sometimes it's the other way around. But in the games when we had great all four quarters playing good football to our ability, we made some noise in those games. But it's all about consistency in the NFL.
Going back to what you mentioned about JJ's quote, did you feel there wasn't a total buy-in from everyone this year with folks not giving 100%? Did you feel like that?
No. I think you can see it on the sideline in every one of our losses. No matter what our record was, a loss hurts. Hurts the pride, man. So I'm just proud to fight with these teammates, and I'm lucky to have them because with a year like this, it is easy to just say, whatever, let's focus on next year. Let's go tanking. No, we came out every game and tried to win, and I have all the respect for my teammates for that.
What are the traits that you look for in possibly a new head coach?
I mean, that's not really my job to hire coaches. I'm just going to play for whoever I play for next year. Going to give them 100% on special teams and offense.
Would you like to see Raheem Morris back next year for the Falcons as the head coach?
I love to see Raheem Morris back. You know, he's a great coach. Obviously, he had nothing to do with personnel this year. He just worked with what he had, and I feel like he did a good job.